came along, since you came along. Your touch is sunlight through the trees, your kisses are the ocean breeze. Everything's alright when you're with me.
Bacala, we're just making this video to let you know that we're sad to see you leave, but we have a few words before you go. I'd like to say that you've made an impact on my life because you've been one of the best art teachers I've ever had. You've helped me in so many ways because, unlike other art teachers that have told me where to go, you've just let me go my own path and open my mind to more creative ideas. And you have a very open classroom that I love spending time in. I'm really going to miss you.
It's impacted my life because I'm a very artsy person, and throughout dance and singing and art, I've always had a coach or a teacher or somebody say, like, you're not enough, like, you don't have any talent, like, you're not doing anything right. And Ms. Bacala, didn't matter what I was doing, didn't matter anything at all, she always thought of me as enough, and it felt really good to have someone in your life who thought that you could do anything you wanted, and that's why I want to become an artist, is because of her.
Ms. Bacala impacted my life because she's made me strive to be better in everything I do, and she's really making me think if, like, what do I do in art, and she keeps asking those questions, so thanks.
Something that I want everybody to know about Mrs. Bacala is how big of a heart that she has and how brilliant she is whenever it comes to art. I wish I had her knowledge about art and about art history.
Bacala is a mentor and has made me a better person and a better artist.
My favorite memory of Mrs. Bacala was going to her house the first time and checking it out, because she lives in a Martha Stewart house in Gladstone. If you've never been to her home, which students probably wouldn't have been there, she has a very awesome home. She's an immaculate housekeeper. The grounds are perfect, the grass is perfect, the flowers are perfect. It's a picture perfect home, so that's probably my best memory of her. Other than that, she has a sweet personality. She's very caring about students and fellow staff members, and I will be sad to see her leave. But I wish her the best of luck in her future plans.
My favorite memory with Ms. Bacala is probably talking about how much we both like Snoopy together, because she's really cute and she likes Snoopy just like I do.
Hi, Anita. This is Floyd, and you know that. I've known you for 10 years, and I was told a long time ago that life's just a book, and you wrote a lot of chapters in the past, and I'm proud to be one of them right now in this chapter. And when this chapter's over, you're writing a new one, so I wish you luck, and I hope I'm part of the rest of the book.
Ms. Bacala, I can't believe you're retiring. How can someone so young be retiring already? I remember when you came here, and you're so sweet and so kind, and you have stayed that way the entire time you've been here. All the things you've done for our kids, you've gotten creativity pulled out of students who probably had little to none. The artwork that has gone through the hallways of this school, amazing, and a lot of it is due to you and your sense of educating children and helping them find their creative mode. My favorite memory of you would probably be the day you came to school and your room was a wreck. Unfortunately, students, someone left it a horrible mess. And although it's funny now, it wasn't funny then, but it was a moment I have never seen you upset in the entire time you're here. My other favorite memory is the day I came to your house and got to see your beautiful home, and you did a huge favor for me and made an amazing heartfelt gift for a member of my family. And I will never ever forget that as long as I live, and I will miss you terribly. Enjoy your family, enjoy your grandchildren, and please keep in touch.
It's a better place since you came along. It's a better place since you came along.